Okay, good morning, 8th class students. Today I am discuss about organization of group food data, interpretation of group food frequency distribution. Okay, now enter to the lesson or chapter, organization of group food data. You see and observe the matter. We have learned to organize smaller data by using tally marks in previous class. But what happens if the data is large? We organize the data of dividing into convenient groups. It is called group data. We organize the data of dividing it into convenient groups. It is called group data. Let us observe the following example. A construction company planned to construct various types of houses for the employees based on their income levels. So they collected the data about monthly net income of the 100 employees who wish to have a house. They are in rupees 15,000, 15,750, 16,000, 16,000, 15,000, 16,400, 16,600, 16,800, and etc. 75,000. Okay. This is a large data of 100 observations ranging from 15,000 to 75,000. Even if we make frequency table for each observation, the table becomes large. Instead of the data can be classified into small income groups like 10,001 to 20,000, 20,001 to 30,000, etc., 70,001 to 80,000. These small groups are called class intervals. The intervals 10,001 to 20,000 has all the observations between 10,001 and 20,000, including both 10,001 and 20,000. This form of class interval is called inclusive form. What is that inclusive form? Where 10,001 is the lower limit, 20,000 is the upper limit. Okay. 10,000 is the lower limit. 10,001 is the lower limit. 20,000 is the upper limit. New words are introduced. Lower limit, upper limit. Lower limit, upper limit. Okay. Interpretation of grouped frequency distribution. Example. Okay, marks of 30 students in mathematics test are given in the adjacent group frequency distribution. Okay, serial number, marks, number of students. 1, 0 to 5 marks, 5 students, 5 to 10 marks, 7 students, 10 to 15, 10 students, 15 to 20, 6 students, 20 to 25, 2 students. Okay, you see the table. I ask some questions. Into how many groups the data is classified? How many groups the data is classified? The data is classified into 5 groups or 5 classes. 5 groups or 5 classes. Okay. Next question. How many students are there in the third group? You see, third group, there are 10 students in the third group. Next question. If a student gets 10 marks, should he be included in second or third class? If a student gets 10 marks, should he be included in second or third class? You see the table? 5 to 10, 10 to 15. Here, already not. 10 is upper limit. This 10 is lower limit. Okay. Here 10 is the upper limit of second class. And lower limit of third class. In such case, upper limit is not included in the class. So, 10 is included in the third class interval. Third class interval. Next, what are the marks of 6 students who are in fourth class interval? What are the marks of 6 students who are in fourth class interval? Fourth class interval is 15 to 60. Marks of 6 students in fourth class interval varies from 15 and below 20. 15 and below 20. Last question. What are the individual marks of 2 students in the fifth group? What are the individual marks of 2 students in the fifth group? You see, 20 to 25, that is, individual marks of students cannot be identified from this frequency distribution. They may be from 20 and below 25. Okay, 20 and below 25. Okay, you see questions, you see the answers. Okay, you see the answers. Do this. Age of 90 people in an apartment are given in the adjacent grouped frequency distribution. One table is here, ages, number of people. You will answer the following questions. I will see the answers tomorrow.